Hello YouTube, welcome back to my tutorial. Today I am back with another module in Python, which is FB chat. This is also known as the Facebook chat messenger for Python. So we can use this module to connect to our Facebook account, and you can do everything that you do on a Facebook page directly from this Python module. Okay, so we'll start with how do we install it. Okay, so you have to install this module using pip install fb chat. So you have to run this command. So make sure you are running this command as the admin user, because otherwise you will get some error. Okay, so you have to run pip install fb chat. So it will install the latest version of FB chat into your system. Okay, so and you should always run this as the root user. Okay, fine. So I will not run this. This is already there in my system. Okay, so let's go ahead. So this is a module which is, you can, if you want to see the help, so just import from FB chat import clients, and then just run this help client. So there is a class in this module called client, which is used to connect to your account and perform the activities. Okay, so you can read this help and, you know, try to understand by yourself. Okay, so it has a init method. Okay, so it is a constructor. So it takes the user ID or the email ID, and then the password. Okay, and then these are the extra parameters that you can give. Okay, so this is how you can connect to your Facebook account. So I will go one by one, and in this tutorial I'll discuss how we can connect to your Facebook account, how we can search for a user, how you can search for a page, how you can search for a group, or how you can, you know, send a message to certain user, and so on. Okay, so okay, so we'll go one by one. So let's say I go to my, do it directly on the prompt itself. So from FB chat import client. So this is the class I'm importing. Okay, and then this is a constructor. So I'll create an object from this class. Okay, so object one is equal to client, and then we have to pass the user ID and the password. Okay, so for user ID and password, I will use the username which is given in a file, rather, because I cannot show the username and password here. So what I will do is I will open a file which is containing the user ID and password, because I want it to be hidden. Okay, so I'll open the file in read mode. Okay, so now I'll store the user ID into user ID variable. Okay, dot read, so it will store my user ID. Fine. Now I have kept the user ID into user ID variable. Similarly, I have another file which is containing the Facebook password. So I can open it using the read mode, binary mode. Okay, so again password is equal to file 2 dot open. Okay, so I'll just preferences. Just thinking, how do I increase the font? Okay, yeah, okay, fine. So let's you know, make it look a little bit bigger so it'll be easy to read. Okay, so I'll open this second second file to read the password. Okay, so my password is stored in password. Okay, now I'll try to log into my account. So to log into your account, all you have to do is you have to either you can create you log in using the constructor init itself, or you can use the dot login method. Okay, so let's say I am creating a client object is equal to client, and then you have to pass the user ID and then the password. Okay, and then you can also give, like, you know, maximum retry count that you want to specify, session cookie, the logging level, and etc. So we are not using those here. Okay, so let's try to log in first. Okay, so I'm trying to log in here, so let's see if it's working or not. Okay, so I'm logged in here. You can see this is login is successful. So if you want to check, okay, let's if I'm logged in or not, so there is a method called is logged in. It will return the object name is client one. Okay, so it will return true or false depending on whether you are logged in or not. Okay, so I'm logged in, fine. So I'm logged in here. So now let's move further, and we try to understand other methods in this class. So there are several methods, as you can see there. You can change nickname, you can change the thread color, or you can, you know, these are all the methods. You can go one by one and you can understand. So let's say I want to search a user. Okay, so what I will do is I will do client dot search. There is a method called search for users, and it will, and you have to specify the name of the person that you want to search. Let's say I want to search for, anything. Yeah, let's say Mukesh. Okay, let's see if we are able to get it or not. And then see, it takes two parameters. First the name, and the second is the maximum number of results that you want to see. So let's say I want to give 5. So it will give you 5 peoples. Okay, so you can see I got 5 names with this. So you will, what you will get is you will get the username plus the user ID. Okay, so these are the friends which are there in your list. Okay, yeah. So this will return a list. So what we'll do is we will store this into a variable. It will return into a list. So it will, so what I'll do is I will store the output of this result into a variable. I'm sorry, so this is client one, right? Yeah, so if you see, if you now print the friends, it will have the entire list. So if I simply print friend 0, so it will give me the first, it will give me the first name in that list. Okay, so now let's say I want to get the user ID of this user. Okay, so here if you see why it is coming as this name, because, okay, yeah, I was searching here. See, I have searched here with Gautam, so it came as Gautam. Yeah, I was surprised why it was coming, because previously I did with Mukesh. Okay, so that's all, that's not a problem. Okay, so now to get the user ID of a user, all you have to do is you have to do that name dot UID. Okay, so friends 0 dot UID will print the UID of that user. So if you see, this is the username and this is the user ID. Okay, so I'll store the user ID into a variable. Okay. Okay. So UID is equal to, okay, so my UID is stored in UID, right? So let's say I want to send a message to this person. Okay, so there is the method in Python, which is used to send a message. So you can directly search for that. Okay, so here you see send. Send is a method which is used to send message. So you need to give message and then the thread ID. Okay, the thread ID or the user ID of the person. Okay, so you see thread ID is the user ID or the group ID to who you want to send the message. Okay, so let's try to do that. Okay, so what is my object? Client one dot send, and then the message. Okay, so the message, instead of message we have this models, right? So in that models we have a message. Okay, so FB chat dot models dot message, and then we put the message, any message, yeah. Let's say hi. Okay, anything, yeah. Hello dear, hello, call them, yeah. Okay, and then this is the message and then the user ID, so which is there in my user ID variable. Okay, so you see here FB chat is not defined, so I think you need to import FB chat as well. FB chat, okay, fine. So let's try to run this command. Okay, so now you see this is what happening. So my message is sent. Okay, if you want to confirm whether the message is sent or not, so I have sent it to who? I have sent it to Gautam Kumar. Let's go to my Facebook account. So if I go to my messages, you see right away at 4:50 at this time I sent a message, hello Gautam, and is there responding also, you know, because he never knows that I am doing it just for the tutorial. Okay, so let's try to send one more message, because if he is responding, so we'll just put a formal message. I think. Okay, settle it down. Okay, so we'll go again and this message will be sent. You see, if I go here to my account and again if I go here, see, nothing is there, nothing is sent. So it's working. I was just giving you an idea how you can send a message. Similarly, you can send emoji also. You know, there is a method called send emoji, using which you can send emoji also, the emoji that the laughing emoji, etc. So let's see something else. Let's say I want to search for a page. Okay, so client one dot search for page. Okay, so I have a page, shankeesportal.com. Let's say if it's coming or not. Okay, I'm sorry, waiting for closer, right? Search for pages, I believe. Okay. So this is the page which came as a result. So this guy is responding so many times. Okay, I'll just disconnect. Okay, so if I search the same page here, I just wanted to confirm whether this page ID is same or not, because I want to confirm that this is the actual page which it is giving. Okay, so if I go to my page, if I go to about, and if I go to page ID, so this is the page ID. I'm sure this will match my page. Okay, so it's matching here, so you can see that 693 is matching the page ID. Okay. So this is right. Okay. This is how you can search a page, you can search a user, you can search a group. Okay, so that's all for this tutorial. In my next tutorial I will discuss something else, reply to someone's message directly from here, or we will try to send a friend request. We can send a birthday wishes to someone directly on his birthday, and we can automate that, how we can directly send a message, a birthday message to someone on his birthday. So this is all we can do using this module at WeChat. So that's all for now, and please keep watching my videos, and that's all. Thanks for watching.